You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
Hey guys, Eric here with from Diesel Dogs Kennels with Bully Badass TV, and I'm here to talk to you guys about what is healthy within our bullies. We think of bully as pretty buff, staunch, muscular looking dogs, but a lot of these dogs come out overweight. And with being overweight, it changes their function and their health. Overweight dogs definitely have a tendency to have more health issues. They're less active. We need to determine what's healthy and what's just a little bit beyond, to maybe even the point of, you know, we could use a word like obese or overweight or fat, but you know, you got to know what you're looking at. And we get caught up too many times to where like, I want bully, I want extreme features, but you lose those extreme features when you're just trying to use the added weight. You know, you don't get to see the muscularity of the dog, the bone that you maybe wanted to add to your program, or, you know, just different various parts of the dog that you're trying to improve. Rock-cum. You know, when we look at our dogs to assess them and address them, you know, we have pet weight, we have working weights, and then we have condition weights. And our condition weights and our working weights are generally very, you know, similar in each other. Then we have pet weights. Rock-cum. And within our pet weight, we want to be able to look at our dog, see a silhouette of the body to where the dog's undercarriage isn't sunken down heavy, looks like it's more to the ground. We want to be able to see a dog that, you know, you can see the muscle, you can see the bone without losing it within excess skin or excess fat of the dog. We want to be able to visually see some of the ribs, maybe even see one of the last one or two ribs to where they stick out. When we touch the dog, we want to be able to feel them. You know, we want to be able to feel the ribs. You can see the ribs right here. I'm just pushing through a layer of skin at this moment, not even a whole lot of fat. Roz, far from condition at the moment. He's not at a working weight. He's at a healthy pet weight, you know. He's been recovering, and you know, a lot of times we all go through things with our dogs, you know, a surgery, maybe an accident, maybe an injury. So is what we need to do is we need to be able to see a tuck in the dog, you know, to where the waistline comes up to meet with the hip in the intersection right here. You know, we don't want a dog that's blown out, heavy, sagging in the belly, and extreme at that point. We want to see our dogs that are maybe extreme in features through the front, like the bone, the chest, extra width. We want to see the muscularity in the dogs, the muscles through them, and you know, be able to touch them and tell what's going on with them. You know, a lot of the times, you know, we'll go to assess a dog and we don't do it properly because we really didn't put our hands on them. You know, sometimes you got to touch your dog, know what's going on, pet them, feel them, give them a massage, know what their body feels like, know what their muscles are. You know, they like that point to where you interact with them, give them a little extra of attention, but we're also assessing, is my dog fat in this area? Like, these are the things that like we really need to think about with our dogs, because this dude's 8 years old. I need him for another 8 years. He is my friend, he is my companion, and I need him for that. And if I allow him to stay at an unhealthy pet weight getting older, it's going to take his life away from him. But overweight dogs, we end up with arthritis, bad joints, hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, you know, impingements within the spine as the dog gets older, because they can't handle the weight that's underneath them that comes through. It changes the entire function of the dog, the mental attitude of the dog. And a lot of times, overweight dogs, you will see, are dogs that have bad reactions to people or children or basic stimuli around the house, because that weight puts pressure on different various parts of the body, which creates pain. The way that they exercise and work is the same way that they love. And we're not showing them what they need by overfeeding them, trying to get features that aren't really there just by having extra weight on them. So guys, do yourselves a favor, grab your dog, touch them, feel them, see if you can pull some extra skin. With that skin, see if there's an extra pudge underneath it. You know, when you grab it, you should be able to watch the skin all fold together, touch it, see, you know, not a whole lot of fat underneath this guy. But, you know, he's still got, you know, a little area to grab, stuff to do. You know, strong rear in an 8-year-old dog that's still here. Doesn't have a whole lot of extra weight. This guy's maybe 90 pounds right now at this point in his life. Good pet weight, decent activity level, good dog, nice and healthy. So with that being said, let's, you know, get active, do a little bit more with our dogs and physically assess their health to where they can be with us longer as a companion. Thank you for watching. This is Bully Badass TV.